Electric blue is a bright, vivid shade of blue, the color of an electric spark. In everyday use, the name electric blue can refer to a range of bright blues varying in intensity. Generally, the hue is considered to be a bright cyan. Lighter than shades like royal blue, but darker than baby blue or pastel blue. While bright blue shades have existed since antiquity, electric blue was not used as a color name in English until 1845. The color would go on to be in vogue in the 1890s. The shade was originally named after the color of the ionized air glow produced during electrical discharges. More than 2,000 years ago, the Greek philosopher Thales is said to have been the first to observe this electrical property. While watching his daughter spin on a spindle made of amber, he noticed the way the amber attracted stray threads. Later, Greek scientists discovered that if they rubbed amber with woolen cloth in a darkened room, it would give off tiny blue sparks. It's now also considered a representation of the color of lightning and any vibrant blues that are metaphorically electric. Its association with electricity means electric blue communicates energy, action, and excitement. Electric blue lights made with neon gas and mercury were invented in 1915. They were commonly used in signs until the 1990s when tube lighting went into decline due to innovations such as flat-screen TVs that allowed for more dynamic commercial signs. Japan still has countless neon lights from this era in operation today. Electric blue is largely associated with the 1980s as this was peak time for neon colors. The color in the 80s appeared in fiction and song as a descriptive term, particularly for blue eyes. For example, the Australian rock band Ice House had a pop hit in 1987 called Electric Blue. The color has often popped up as a popular hue in menswear. Shocking blue, a bright electric blue, is a somewhat more masculine inverse to its more feminine counterpart, shocking pink. Long ago, the color would represent a futuristic view, but now in contemporary fiction and songs, it is more likely to be used as an analogy for nostalgia and longing for the past.